Ah, look what I've done. Now I shall never make it to Starbucks. Unless...
it's the money.
Now this only works if it was my bad in the first place. I chose a poor line, overcooked the throttle, and just need a fresh start. However, if the sand is to blame, then my second attempt will get me just as stuck as the first.
After some miscellaneous B-roll to emphasize the time that takes,
I recently put a car tire on a motorcycle with surprising results. And if that fit between my swing arm,
then car traction aids will too. Every Canadian knows how these can paddle your land canoe out of a snowy parking spot. Turns out, they'll row your bike out of most sticky spots too.
Motorcycle winches exist. Like FortNine exists, we're not happy about it. They're costly, clunky, hard to install, hard to use, and murder to your motorcycle's battery. But there's something useful hiding in there.
Synthetic winch cable, bought separately for a few purple bills.
I always carry this. It's strong. 7,700 pounds of weight over engineering. Packs down small and light. Actually floats on water. Should we get a shot of it floating on water? If you actually edit it in, I'll know we were super thin for footage.
But more importantly, the winch cable's eyelets hook up faster than Tinder dates.
Now I've turned a limited number of gripping points and angles into a whole spectrum of perfect pulling power. From as far away as I need to find solid footing.
You don't really need special rope for this. I said you don't really need special rope for this.
Yeah, not really. It's more for the next one, so we'll just chapter cut to it quick right after this.
Canadian nightmare. There's nobody a boot to help oot. So, relax, eh? Tie from the bike, around an anchor, and back to the bike. Now, you're glad to have winch cable, made from special abrasion-resistant nylon, and sporting a sleeve for protecting the rope around your anchor. And when you put a stick between the lines and start to twist, you'll be glad that winch cable is inelastic. It stores no energy.
So as I crank down on my jumbo tourniquet, even if the rope snapped, it wouldn't slap back. Of course you can do this with a ratchet strap too, but no man or woman desires a tool that is rather short and all spent after a few tugs.
Besides, rope is more flexible. I could use this to make a Z-drag if I'm spoiled for anchors. It could be my clothesline or tarp cord in the meantime, and it'll be irreplaceable for the last trick. It's possible to use a motorcycle's rear wheel to winch itself out. But no one ever talks about this, so pay attention.
Tie that winch cable to a couple spokes, then outside the spokes but inside the brake disc, spool it around the hub a few times. This keeps the winching force on the wheel center, which is strong, and off the spokes I tied to, which aren't.
Now the other side of the rope goes to my tree.
Thank you.
Now the other side of the rope goes to my anchor. I've been very clever here and buried a dead man.
A green log 2 feet deep will hold a Hummer, let alone a bike.
So I just use the motor to slowly spin the wheel, to winch in the cable, to pull out the bike. Granted, this is far from flawless. I can see it busting a spoke, busting my rope, or winding so tight against the brake disc that it takes a few minutes to unwind.
But it works. And when there's a question of getting my bike out and getting home, or not, hell yes, that's the trick.
That does the trick. Oldest trick in the book, this. Well, I have a trick up my sleeve. Might be a dirty trick, but it works.